Good morning, and welcome to worship this fourth Sunday of Easter, and a special welcome to those who may be watching online or a recording, just so that you are aware, a bulletin for the service is available on our website, oslcgreatfalls.org, under the events page at the bottom. Today is Change for Change Sunday. The offerings this quarter, are for the free lunch bags that are given away at First United Methodist Church. So we will be collecting for this month and the next two in order for those for that ministry. And the cans for that are at the back alongside the offering plate. Braden is here today, Braden Maynard, and he took education classes for First Communion and has not been able to do that until today. So he's here. So today he will receive communion first when we come to that part of our worship service, and we celebrate with him on this step in his faith life. Let's prepare our hearts and minds for worship. Before we begin, I did want to mention my wireless mic is taking a vacation day for whatever reason, so I will be in the pulpit so that you all may hear me. Please rise as you are comfortable. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the keeper of the covenant, the source of steadfast love, our rock and our Redeemer. Amen. God hears us when we cry and draws us close in Jesus Christ. Let us return to the one who is full of compassion. Fountain of living water, pour out your mercy over us. Our sin is heavy and we long to be free. Rebuild what we have ruined and mend what we have torn. Wash us in your cleansing flood. Make us alive in the Spirit to follow in the way of Jesus as healers and restorers of the world you so love. Amen. Receive the good news. Children of God, God's word never fails. The promise rests on grace. By the saving love of Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God, our sins are forgiven, and God remembers them no more. Journey in the way of Jesus. Amen. You may be seated.
Song, cherubim of heavenly
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Oh, excuse me. Kyrie. Let us pray. O Lord Christ, good shepherd of the sheep, you seek the lost and guide us into your fold. Feed us, and we shall be satisfied. Heal us, and we shall be whole. Make us one with you, for you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The first reading is from 1 John, the third chapter. We know love by this, that Jesus Christ laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for one another. How does God's love abide in anyone who has the world's goods and sees a brother or sister in need and yet refuses help? Little children, let us love, not in word or speech, but in truth and action. By this, we will know that we are from the truth and will reassure our hearts before him whenever our hearts condemn us. For God is greater than our hearts, and he knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have boldness before God, and we receive from him whatever we ask because we obey his commandments and do what pleases him. And this is his commandment, that we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another, just as he has commanded us. All who obey his commandments abide in him, and he abides in them. And by this we know that he abides in us, by the Spirit that he has given us. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And then a reading of Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. The Lord makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters. You restore my soul, O Lord, and guide me along right pathways for your name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup is running over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I invite you to stand as you are comfortable for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel according to John, the 10th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because a hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated. Well, have you ever wondered what it is about Psalm 23 that makes it so very popular? Well, there's a lot of action in that particular psalm. There are things like leading and comforting and restoring and guiding. And it's not obvious that God is busy. God is with us. God is active. But it's not just really about being busy for busyness' sake, because there is a so that I will not fear, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, so that my and our cup runs over now, and so that at one day we will dwell with God, we'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And perhaps it's those words in the psalm that take us to what happens that Jesus is talking about in the Gospel of John. That he is the good shepherd. He is not like the one who runs away or who turns away from the troubles that the sheep get into. And goodness knows, we sheep find ourselves in a lot of difficulties at all sorts of times. Maybe we find ourselves in difficulty in an operating room or a funeral home. Maybe we find ourselves in difficulty in a jail cell or in somehow in the midst of the anger and the fear of racism. Maybe we find ourselves in difficulty or a dark place in the midst of some sort of an argument or in an exam that we didn't really prepare for. And so we wonder in those dark and difficult times, we can't see Jesus with our eyes and we can't feel Jesus with our hands. Is Jesus really with us? Are we alone? Has Jesus forgotten us? Do we not even matter anymore? Is Jesus even real? And to that question, Jesus says this emphatic, no, I have not forgotten you. I am with you. I am the good shepherd. I have not run away. I'm willing to follow you and be with you in the midst of whatever dark place you may find yourself. But I was reminded this week of the question, but wait a minute. What if the good shepherd stands with the sheep and somehow then is killed? Is killed. Somehow, then what happens to the rest of the sheep? What happens to the rest of the flock if the shepherd has laid down his life for the sheep? I mean, does that mean now that they are somehow even more vulnerable to the enemy? Well, in the case of Jesus as our good shepherd, the answer is Jesus did not stay dead. Yes, he laid down his life, but he took it back up again. That's what we celebrate in this season of Easter, that Jesus did not stay in the tomb. Jesus rose. Jesus came back so that Jesus is with us always. Like I said, whether or not we can see him or feel him. And that reminds me of a story that I read many years ago. It seems that this person had found herself in a very dark and lonely place. And she had a visitor. Someone came to see her. And even though it was a sunny day outside, the inside of the house was dark. The curtains were drawn, the lights were off. And after they'd visited for a little while, the person said, "You know, I just find myself to be in such a place that I just can't feel Jesus' presence. I just can't even imagine that Jesus cares. I'm even to the point where I just don't believe." And so to that, the visitor said, "Well, let me ask you a question. Do you believe that the sun is shining outside?" And the person said, "Well, I can't see it, and I can't feel it. I mean, I suppose that I believe it, but I have my doubts." And to that, the visitor reached and pulled back the curtain, and the sun came flooding into the room and said, "See, even though you can't see it or feel it, doesn't mean that the sun isn't shining, doesn't mean that the sun isn't real. Just like Jesus' love and presence with and for us." And that brings us back to Psalm 23 and those assurances that God is with us no matter what, no matter where, no matter when. And what we hear in 1 John and the Gospel of John, that Jesus is the one who laid down his life for us and knows us, knows our voice is with us so that we are with him. Again, no matter what, no matter where. It's what we celebrate. It's why we declare in this Easter season that, "Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia."
Thank you.
Living together in trust and hope, our faith is confessed through the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Alive in the risen Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Shepherding God, call your church to your loving embrace. Strengthen us to hear your voice and share your message with the world. You have created all that we need. Heal the places where your creation needs renewal and help us to be faithful stewards of land, water, air, and creatures. The nations and peoples are yours. Place into the hearts of all leaders and rulers the passion to serve with mercy. You are the leader of this faith community. Lead, guide, direct, and shepherd us to face the challenges and the opportunities presented to us. Your love flows out to those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Grant your healing touch to all who are in need, especially those we remember before you now. You hold us securely in your loving hands. In the assurance of resurrection hope, we remember our loved ones who have died in you, trusting you that one day you will bring us all together to dwell with you forever. In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. As I go to prepare for communion, I invite you from where you are to share a sign of your of Christ's peace with one another. Peace be with you all. I invite you to stand as you are comfortable. God, you are indeed almighty, merciful, and holy. Great is the majesty of your glory. You love the world so much that you gave your only Son so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. We give thanks for his coming into the world to accomplish all things for our salvation. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." We pray together as our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. We may rest assured that all of Christ's promises and benefits are found in one of the elements. I will be bringing the host to you. The gifts of God for the people of God. body and the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. Wellspring of joy, through this meal you have put gladness in our hearts. Satisfy the hunger still around us and send us as joyful witnesses that your love may bring joy to the hearts of all people. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Receive the blessing. May our glorious God grant you a spirit of wisdom to know and to love the risen Lord Jesus, the God of life, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Bless you now and forever. Amen.
Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Go in peace. Share the good news. Thanks be to God. Alleluia.